When the doors closed to outsiders, Marie Tripp could still see inside Orchard Villa, a live video feed from her mother's room that stunned her.
My mom was so dehydrated, she had the call button in her hand. She was trying to drink from the call button.
Tripp believes no one was bringing her mom water.
They were so short-staffed.
We didn't know the full extent of what these residents were dealing with.
Ontario's premier has said he didn't know how bad it was until the military moved in reporting on conditions. But just released reports show his government's own inspectors were called in for multiple issues, even visiting up to the day the home was locked down. Warning a resident had been dressed in stained clothing, residents who did not receive scheduled baths or showers on shifts that were short-staffed, allegations residents were facing verbal and physical abuse from staff, captured by a video camera but wasn't immediately reported in contravention of the rules.
I don't see how there's a way around pulling their license.
This NDP MPP questions why, after years of documented problems, things didn't change until dozens had died.
It's infuriating to know that they had access to this information. They've known about it. They have chosen to kind of just let it sit to allow a home like this to continue.
In a statement, Ontario's government says the military was there precisely because we knew this home was in dire need of support, while Orchard Villa says it will address the findings in the inspection reports, noting some staff are no longer with the home.
We called her the queen of the family.
Whatever changes might happen now come too late for Tripp's mom, Mary Walsh. She is among the 78 dead at Orchard Villa. David Common, CBC News, Toronto.